Hello again, everybody. I know what you're thinking. Man, it's been a long time since old Nate Dad put some content out. Well, there's a few reasons for that. So it has been a minute since I did anything here on my channel, and there's a few reasons for that. The short of it is 2021 has been a kick in the pants. There's been a lot going on. Some of you know that my sister passed a little unexpectedly, and that was really difficult. Not to mention the fact that this whole COVID thing has continued to go on like it has been. It's been winter time, and I've been locked indoors and not able to do a lot of hiking until recently, and I found myself in a bit of a funk. In short, my mind was occupied with things that were not very positive or productive. So I had to do something about that.
The good news is life is a bunch of seasons. What I mean by that is there was a time when I had a orange Mustang in high school. That was a season. There was a time when my kids were in middle school. That was a season. There was a time that was 2020. That was a season. And I think we can all agree that 2020 was like nothing else we've ever seen. It was crazy on a lot of fronts, and it impacted people in a lot of different ways. It was a dark time. And I know for myself, even coming out of 2020, meaning transitioning in January from 2020 to 21, there were still a lot of question marks. There were still a lot of things that were unsettled. And as much as I hate to say it, I got caught up in thinking about and worrying about a lot of things that are not on my plate. Let me explain. So there's a great prayer out there that has been abbreviated, and it is basically called the Serenity Prayer. And it reads something like this: God, grant me the serenity to accept the things that I cannot change, the courage to change the things that I can, and the wisdom to know the difference. So for me, I love this prayer. It's a great tool, but I always kind of review it in reverse. It's important to first acquire the wisdom to know the difference between what is your responsibility and what is not your responsibility. And for me, you know, there were so many things in the last year that were just completely out of control, and I mean in no one's control, but also not really managed in a cohesive, intelligent, logical way. And so that grated on a lot of people. And so there was a lot of darkness and frustration and anger and animosity and bitterness and et cetera, et cetera, et cetera, darkness in the world. And eventually it overflows into everyone's lives, because even though we want to stay distant, we still love our friends. We love our family. We love those people and those things that we've always been attached to and associated with for the past X number of years in our lives. And suddenly there was an exclamation point that said, stop, go no further, you can't do that anymore, and we all had to figure it out. Wisdom to know the difference. The difference from what? So the first part of that prayer reads, God, grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change and the courage to change the things that I can. So we've talked about the fact that you need to have a little bit of wisdom in your life to determine what's your responsibility and what's not, but then you have to understand that some things we have absolutely no control over, no power over, and therefore we need God's help just navigating that. And then the other half is things that we do have some input in that we need to be courageous enough to act accordingly and take things seriously enough to know when to move our feet and when not to move our feet. That falls back to the wisdom. And for me, sometimes those things get a little skewed and or confusing, because I really believe that I have more power than I really do. And so I get caught up in things that are not my responsibility, not my control, and I try to fix them. I try to control, change, and fix things that I have no business being a part of. That's because I'm selfish and I'm prideful. I remember the day someone pointed out the fact that I am incapable of changing the past, but I have complete control over how I perceive the past and what I do to allow it to affect where I'm at today and what I do in the future. It's important for us to understand that while the past is a defining factor in who we are, it does not determine who we are. It only contributes to the way that we view ourselves. And sometimes the things that are poured into our lives are not fair, are not right, are not truth. They can just be darkness. And if we allow those moments and those situations to dictate who we are, who we perceive ourselves to be, we're doing ourselves a disservice. We're focusing on the flesh and not the truth, which is found in the Spirit, the eternal. So originally I started out by telling you that there'd been a reason for me not putting out any content. The bottom line is that I was really focused on what was going on around me in the flesh, in the world, things that I have absolutely no control over, things that impact me a little bit, but really not that much at all right now, and trying to fix, change, and control people, places, and things, all of which I have zero control over. The only thing I have any kind of control over, falling back to, is my second thought, because anybody can interject a thought into your mind, chocolate cake, and then you're going to be thinking about that for a second. So I have only control over my second thought and what I'm doing with my hands. And I need to take advantage of opportunities and moments and be light. That means loving my neighbors, loving my enemies, and staying out of God's business. You know, understanding what is my responsibility to accept and what is my responsibility to try and move and work in a way that honors and glorifies Him. Because left to my own devices, I'm a train wreck. You know, I am self-centered at the core. You probably are as well. And so most of my ideas, most of my concepts are based on what benefits me. And that doesn't benefit anyone other than me. And typically it doesn't benefit myself either. Because sometimes I think I know what I need, but that's really just what I want. And sometimes the things that I want are going to be detrimental to me long term. So
I started off telling you about my issue with really just the wrong focus on life. And here's the trick. There's a song out there, and one of the lyrics says, if you're looking for worries, you've got them. And the truth that that exposes is that if our focus is on problems, if our focus is on troubles, worries, concerns, evil, darkness, whatever you want to call it, you will not find a shortage. You can continue to find things that are bad, are wrong, are broken, need attention, need addressed, need fixed in the world, because it is a fallen and broken world. We're just part of that. So I had to change what I was looking at, what I was focused on, and what my thoughts were about. And so to quote my favorite life coach of all time, he said it like this: do not lay up for yourselves treasures on earth where moth and rust destroy and where thieves break in and steal, but lay up for yourselves treasure in heaven, where neither moth nor rust destroys, and where thieves do not break in and steal. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also. And then I got a brother from another mother who said it kind of like this: finally, brothers, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is commendable, if there is any excellence, if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things. What you have learned and received and heard and seen in me, practice these things, and the God of peace will be with you. The problem I run into is I'm a fixer by nature. When I see a problem, or I see something that is wrong or broken, I want to fix it. And sometimes it's not for me to fix. And sometimes it's not something that is going to be fixed, and so I get frustrated. And I lose sight of the truth that is, you know, God says, be still and know that I am God. And sometimes me doing nothing is what's required. And so in the moments of darkness, it's because I feel like I'm overwhelmed with things that aren't as they should be in my mind. And I fail to recognize that I'm very short-sighted. I can only see this far. But as things open up and time reveals what's really in God's plan,
things change. And so sometimes it's not really a matter of me fixing it, it's a matter of me just walking through it. And so I know that there are people who love me and care about me and would be willing to do anything if I just asked, but my pride gets in the way. You know, the world is full of wonderful things. But when I look for worries, when I look for troubles, when I look for darkness and evil, there's also no shortage of those things as well. So I've got to be mindful of my thoughts. I've got to pay attention to where my eyes go.
So the thing I forgot personally is that I've got a wonderful forgetter. It's a very, very, I don't know, good thing, terrible thing, depending on how you look at it. I forget that people love me. I forget that God has put people in my life to show me how much He loves me. I forget that we're only called to act justly, love mercy, and walk humbly with God. We're called to love our neighbors. We're called to love our enemies. But we're called and reminded not to worry and not to get caught up on things that we have no power over. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge Him, and He will make straight your paths. Sometimes I forget. But I thank God that there are people around me that God uses to remind me. It was a rough start to 2021. But every new day is a new chance for hope and a new chance for joy. I'm going to keep plugging along.